I decided to start my year by taking myself up into the Adelaide Hills for a bit of a painting retreat. And I was lucky enough to be able to stay up there for a few days at a wonderful property surrounded by trees, which are always a comfort to me. This place was truly magic. I spent my days by the dam, the spring-fed dam, with the goldfish and the frogs and the birds and the trees, and a beautiful Labrador called Tully. And she didn't leave my side. She was my companion the whole time. And we just spent our day having a look around where we decided to paint each day varied, depending on the light. There's something about being out painting amongst nature that's quite soothing for me. It's very peaceful. No outside sounds apart from nature. I've called this collection Symphony of Nature because that's what it was. It was all of those beautiful sounds that I could hear. It's always a challenge when you're painting outdoors. I decided to set myself a challenge, even more so to work on a larger scale this time. So I took bigger canvases, and that was fun. The light's always changing, and you know, the elements challenge you at times, but it's a really rewarding experience, and I'm really glad I did it. I was able to take my oil paints this time, and I loved working with those. I always spend a bit of time observing the space and the place that I'm in before I start working, and generally just brush in my base with some big shapes. And I'm really painting quite intuitively. You have to work differently, you work a bit faster. I'm just looking constantly up at the light and the shapes and the colours, and it's quite an emotional response to how I feel when I'm out there, more so than recording exactly. I am trying to really capture the textures and the feeling of being out there. That's my main focus. I felt the cold sea kiss my skin. I turned around and you were gone. And I'm thinking of you. Once I start applying the paint a bit thicker with my palette knives, I'm really just building up the layers and really focusing on light and shade and patterns and textures of the bushland around me. And I get to a certain point, especially with the larger works out, plein air work, where I really can't do any more, and it's probably all a bit too wet and I'm getting myself into a bit of mud. So that's the point where I need to stop and give it a break, and then think about sort of maybe reworking it later back in my studio. The small works, when I'm painting plein air, I do on site in one sitting, and they're fun because they're fast and fresh and free and really just capturing the moment. That immediate response is how I really love working in the bush. With this collection, I have got some larger works, and I did paint all of those in my studio, but I was responding to some smaller works that I did out on plein air. So I often have to really upscale from something that I've done really on a small scale, so that was also challenging for me. But I do love working big, and the big works in this show have been really special pieces for me. I've loved it.
You read your fair share of books, and you tied your lace a thousand times. And you saw the good in the worst of the crooks, and your story began. And your story began. The sun had burned, so I jumped right in. I felt the cold sea kiss my skin. I turned around and you were gone.